Namaskar. Welcome to an introductory module on corporate social responsibility and social entrepreneurship. Let us begin with the origin of concept of governance. If people are self-disciplined or they are disciplined because of the respect of parents, teachers or elders, then they would follow the path of dharma, that is their duties, and thus no external force in form of rules and regulations will be required to control or govern them. But this ideal scenario might not be the case always. There may be people who would remain disciplined only through the respect or fear of punishment from the government on violation of the social norms. So, governance is required to ensure that overall social order is maintained and the righteous people remain free from distraction by anti-social elements. So in a nutshell, if we want to define the governance, it can be said that it is a mechanism of collective action to address the social and economic needs of the society. The government or policymaker is a tool in this process. The collective action could be through all these stakeholders like administrators, corporate, entrepreneurs, maybe for-profit, non-for-profit, civil society, media, etc. Now, coming to the corporate governance, just like we need the disciplined individuals for a good social order, we need corporate to follow a financial discipline and also discharge their social and environmental responsibility. The financial part is generally taken care through the audits and the reporting structure as per the norms of Ministry of Corporate Affairs, SEBI and other regulatory authorities. The social and environmental responsibility, this part is generally termed as corporate social responsibility. As we discussed in the definition of governance, that the social and economic needs of the society are primary purpose. So, here we see a representation of how all the stakeholders perform the collective action. The government, through its bureaucratic channel, delivers the public services and creates social good. The corporate do the same through CSR. They might take different routes to achieve it. While an entrepreneur may take the social entrepreneurial approach to deliver the same. This was in nutshell about the CSR and Social Entrepreneurship submodule. Thank you for going through it, and your feedback and queries are welcome at prime@banasthali.in. In the next module, we will discuss further about the CSR and social entrepreneurship. Thanks once again.